We're going to talk about rational expressions. When you think rational, you should automatically think fractions, okay? Let me make it easy to start with. If I have a fraction, like this, what do you know happens because I'm multiplying top and bottom?
Well, the X's will cross out.
The X's will cross out. That's exactly what I wanted you to see. The X's will cross out. So this could simplify as 2y over 5z. Does that make sense to everybody? That's not a hard concept, right? And it's kind of the same concept as when we are, let's see. If I looked at this fraction and I wanted to simplify it, what would you do? You would take a 6 out, right? But this is the same thing as 6 times 3, and this is the same thing as 6 times 4. So essentially what you're doing is writing it as a multiplication problem and crossing out what cancels top and bottom. Does that make sense?
Do it like that?
No, but you're going to have to do it whenever we get into our variable expressions. Well, I'm showing you that. I'm showing you how it works that way because that's kind of what we're going to do with what we're doing today. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is simplify a rational expression. The expression is going to look something like, I think I'll use the one in the book so it factors nicely. I'm asked to simplify this. Okay. Don't start canceling out yet, and here's why. Do you see these subtraction and, or they're actually all subtraction signs, but some subtraction signs there that are not enclosed in parentheses. Meaning I'm not multiplying, I'm adding and subtracting, right? Do you see that? I can't just start crossing stuff out yet. Huh? Yeah. So what I want to do first is write them as simplified multiplication problems. In other words, factor them.
3 times 5 would be 15. 3 less would be
9. Yeah, but you're still trying to, you're trying to simplify, but I can't simplify because I'm adding and subtracting in there right now. So, if you factored, look at the top. How does the top factor? X minus 5, X plus 3. Now, if you need to put that in the box, you can. I hope when there's no leading coefficient that we're all pretty good about factoring it at this point. How about the bottom? Difference of two squares? You're absolutely right. Now look at this a second. I've got something times something, and then on the bottom, something times something else. Do you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Now those whole somethings can cancel out, okay? The key is that these additions and subtractions have to be enclosed in parentheses before you start canceling out, because that indicates multiplication. So then now I can cancel out factors. And what cancels? Can I cancel the X's out now?
Yes.
No, why? That's right. I would have to cancel out the whole term there. I can't just cancel the X out. A lot of you have asked me about that poster at the back before. That's where that poster comes from. Every time you do this, a kitten dies. See how they're crossing the x squared out there in the beginning?
Oh.
You can't do that because it's not multiplying.
Oh, you take a picture of that.
It stays on the wall all the time.
Also,
is that all you can do?
Then you can look up at the wall. All right, so let's look at another one.
Is that all you can do?
That's all you can do, yes, that's all you can do.
So it always ends in parentheses?
It always ends just, it just depends on what you start with as to how it ends. Let's do another one. Let's do... That's a 10x, yeah. That's supposed to be a 3. I'm telling you. It still wanted to go cattywampered. Simplify that expression for me. Try it on your own, and then we'll do it together. Look at it as it sits now. Can you cancel anything out now?
No.
No. Nothing's in parentheses. Well, I mean, I could put parentheses around the whole top and the whole bottom, but those aren't going to cancel. So now let's try to factor everything we can. Look at the top. Can I factor that?
It'd be 2x parentheses x plus 5.
You can take a GCF out. Exactly. You take a 2x out, it's left with x plus 5. Oh. How about the bottom here? I hear nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
You can factor it. What multiplies to 15 but adds to 16? X and 5, 3x and 1. Now can you simplify it? That's all? Yep. Can I cancel these X's out now?
Nope.
Because I got 2X and I got 3X plus 1, so this is my simplified form. Does that make sense? Y'all say, Do another one?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Wait, will we ever be able to factor it more?
What do you mean?
Than that?
It could be a special pattern. Denver's a 2 cube, right. Some are 2 cubes, grouping.
Good right
hand. Sad
milk. Let's
see.
Can you give us
a
harder
one?
That's how I spell
MVP. Well, we're going to be simplifying as we multiply and divide, too. But let me see. How about this one? Try this one. You need me to go back? All right. And then let's divide it by x squared minus 8x plus 15.
We can do the slash.
Yep.
Oh, see, right.
No, you got 4 pieces on top, so you can group it and slash it there.
I forgot how to do that.
Several of you said you couldn't remember how to group. So up top, what can I take out of the first two? X squared. What's left?
X squared minus
3. X minus 5. Now I take a negative 3 out, and what's left? X minus 5.
And then it would be, and you would do it even further.
So it would be, you take the X minus 5 in the front, and then you have the X squared minus 3 left.
I did it backwards.
That's fine. On the bottom here, we have a factor with no leading coefficient. So what multiplies to 15 but adds to 8?
Negative 3, negative 5.
3 and 5, both negatives.
Can you put it in the scorpion?
In the box?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So when we put it in the box, x squared and 15, what multiplies to 15 but adds to 8? Both signs are going to be negative.
That does, yeah.
Why? I don't understand how you get by that.
No.
What multiplies to these two, which is 15x squared, but adds to what's in the middle. So what are the factors of 15 that add to 8? 3x and 5x. 3x times 5x is 15x squared, but 3x plus 5x is 8x. Now what cancels out?
Well, yeah, I did that.
So I'm left with x squared minus 3 over x minus 3. Brianne, you are not in your seat.
She didn't move over there.
Y'all can. All right. Let's multiply. Juliana, put that away. All right. Now, again, these. What? Again, these are fractions, okay? So think about your properties of fractions. If you have two fractions that you're multiplying, what do? Multiply straight across, right? So you get 3x over 2y. Yes? Gonna do the same thing with rational expressions. We're gonna multiply straight across. We're just gonna make sure they're in as simplified factored form as we can get them before we start. So, for example, so I'm gonna put here your key is to factor first. All right. Let's say you have 2x squared minus 10x divided by x squared minus 25 times x plus 3 over 2x squared. We are going to go across, but before we go across, so let me do you when multiplying.
Do we do what we just did?
That's what I would advise, is I would, instead of coming here and trying to FOIL out the top there and everything, I would first factor each fraction completely. So on this, the top, the numerator of the first fraction, how does that factor?
X. 2x.
2x, and what's left?
Parentheses x.
X minus 5. How about the bottom here? Yeah, exactly, because it's a difference of two squares. Can I do anything with either one of those in the second fraction? No. So I'm just going to write it as is. Now what I am going to do is I'm going to put a fraction around that x plus 3, not a fraction, a parenthesis around that x plus 3 so you can see that that's a factor on its own. Yep. So now that I have factored each one completely, I say multiply across, but we've done this before where I said don't make it harder on yourself. This is just one big fraction. Just go straight across like this, right? Because fractions multiply top and bottom times bottom.
Wait, do you have to leave the x minus
5? You can cancel it out if you want to go ahead and cancel it out first. I always, whenever I get to this step, I just make one big fraction out of it and then just start canceling what I can. Is that the only thing that cancels? Mm-hmm. I could do the 2. Now remember, x squared is like x times x, right? So I can cancel this x and one of these x's. Does that make sense? If you used your properties of exponents and you said 1 minus 2, you'd get negative 1 and then flip down to the bottom.
So x plus 3 over x plus 5.
times x.
So then it would be 2 to x. It would be x squared plus 5.
Wait, where are you getting an x squared?
That's as far as you can go.
That's as far as you can go. Don't try to multiply it back out. Leave it as is. Leave it in factored form. Are y'all confused on this part, what canceled there?
Yeah.
Okay, so if you have 2x over 2x squared.
2's cancel, one of the x's.
Okay, the 2's cancel, right?
I thought we couldn't do that.
There's no plus or minus there. It's multiplication. You see? Every plus or minus has to be enclosed in parentheses. So now this is like x over x times x. So now an x cancels here, and I've got 1 over x, which is where this one lonely x came from here. Does that make sense now? Tell me when y'all are caught. Woohoo! You see why I told you never forget factoring?
Yes. Oh, holy. I think factoring is very hard to forget.
What happens if you're multiplying by something that's not in a fraction? You're multiplying by a fraction. You're multiplying a fraction by something that's not a fraction.
Put it over 1.
You put it over 1. Absolutely.
That is right.
Oh.
It is coming back.
All coming back. It's all coming back to you.
They all about to say the 1
capital, but I can can anything cancel out the way it sits now?
Yeah. The 1.
Yeah.
The 1.
What 1 you keep talking about?
The 1 from capital, right?
That 1 doesn't. Did I see anything you can do?
Nah.
Excellent.
But the 1 doesn't have any x's.
What about the x?
That's a difference of 2 cubes. Absolutely. Now the question is, do you remember how to factor a difference of 2 cubes?
Sort of. It's x plus something.
Remember, little parenthesis, big parenthesis.
Yeah, that's what I remember.
Same change plus. Y'all just thought it went away. What times itself 3 times gives you x cubed?
X.
I was going to say that was not rhetorical. What times itself 3 times gives you 1?
1.
You square the first in the first spot, you square the last in the last spot, and you multiply them together for the middle.
And then there will be -1.
And some of you are looking at me like, oh my gosh.
Wait. Don't.
No, you don't worry about signs because you put the signs the same change plus to start with.
I don't
what 2 cancel out, Tanner? That whole entire trinomial there cancels out. So I'm left with x plus 5 over x minus 1. Wow.
That makes sense.
Well, I mean, you could put it there if you wanted to. It'd be like 1 times, but it's implied. Yeah. Yes or no? What you think?
You have to put 1 on the outside right there.
No. How about division? Tell me what happens when you have a fraction.
You're divided.
Divided by
another fraction?
Oh. A fraction.
Wow, you subtract.
Multiply it by the reciprocal. You change it to a multiplication problem. Multiply by the reciprocal.
That all you do?
That's all you do, but we're going to put some...
It's
the same thing.
So, correct. You see how I'm kind of working you into this and start with simplifying. We simplify everything when we're done. We do a multiplication, then we simplify. We do division, which is actually multiplication, then simplification.
Wow.
Okay. Let's look in... It's just a disguise, yes. Yeah. Because we never want to divide by a fraction. Instead, we always want to multiply by the reciprocal. All right. Dang, Tanner, am I boring you?
No, I just don't like it. Why do you, but I don't?
Why? It's fun.
It's all good.
Okay. The key to this chapter is? Starts with an F, factoring. I always, when I start these, I always want to factor everything I can before I start. That's right. So look at the first fraction. Is there anything on the first fraction that I can factor?
The bottom.
I've got 7x over. What factors out on the bottom of the first one? 2. What's left? X minus 5. How about the top here of the second? X, what's left?
Could we go ahead and flip it?
You can.
X minus 6.
How about the bottom? Same signs. X minus 5, X minus 6. I'm going to put same, change, flip, multiply by the reciprocal in better mathematical terms. Take the first, multiply and flip. X minus 5, X minus 6.
I was going
to factor
out,
weren't
you?
Yes.
So the x minus
5
would go and the x minus
6
would go.
And all I have now is an already factored multiplication problem that we did.
7x.
What cancels?
X minus 5 and x minus 6.
And x minus 6. Anything else?
No.
The x.
Okay, yep.
So this big nasty rational expression here actually simplifies down to just 7 over 2. That's pretty cool, right? Yes, yes it is. Shamik is very cool.
I love it.
I do too. I find it very easy. If you're strong in your factoring, this is easy peasy.